Hello, everyone, and welcome to Miss Elaine's Book Nook. We're getting ready to enter another school year already, and part of my job is to help find books to start the school year. Last school year, we did a project called Kids Pick, where we went into the Bethel Park Elementary Schools and we read a different book each month to grades 1 and 2, and then we had the kids pick their favorite. So today, I wanted to share the stories from last year and announce the winner to all of you, and maybe you'll have a favorite too. I also have some special guests on today's show who are about to start school, just as you are. Maybe my friends at home are getting ready to start preschool for the first time. That's exciting. Maybe you're going to kindergarten for the first time. That's super exciting. And maybe some of you are returning to school for your first or second grade year, or your third grade year. Maybe my friends at home still have another year at home, or maybe they go to daycare, but whatever the case may be, school year is upon us. So let's start with you. If you want to turn around and say hello to the camera, tell them who you are.
And
Amara's starting kindergarten for the first time this year, aren't you? Okay, and next we have?
My name is Dominic Brannick, and I'm 8 years old.
And what grade are you going into, Dominic?
I'm going into second grade.
Second grade, nice. And last?
Hi, my name is Dominic Brannick, and I'm going into third grade, and I'm 8 years old.
Awesome. Now, do you guys go to Bethel Park? No. We have two all the way from Michigan who are joining us today. And Miss Natalia here goes to South Fayette. All right, so we're going to see what you guys think about these books. And I'm going to see what my friends at home think about these books. And like I said, at the very end of today's show, we'll announce the 2016 Kids Pick winner. All right, so the first one that we started with last September was by Sarah Gillingham. And it was called How to Grow a Friend. To grow a friend, first, plant a seed in good soil. So they're kind of comparing friendship to a flower, to a garden, right? Because it's the same thing. You plant a seed, you have to put it in soil. You also have to plant a seed of friendship. A friend needs water, warm sunshine, and space to bloom. What do you think that means? They need water and sunshine like flowers do and space to bloom. What do you think that means, space to bloom?
Space.
Like just give them some room?
Yeah.
You don't always have to be together. When you have a best friend, it's great. It's a lot of fun to sometimes play together every day. But do you have to be together every minute of every day? No, it's good to have some space to have your alone time too. To grow a friend, talk and listen. It's important to be a good listener. It doesn't happen overnight. Sometimes a friend bugs you. A friend can get on your nerves sometimes, right? You might have an argument, you might have a fight. To grow a friend, chase the bugs away together. So you work it out, right? Even if you do have a misunderstanding, you work it out. And you chase the bugs away together. And don't let your friend get stuck in the weeds. What do you think that means?
Let him get in a jam.
Don't let them get in a jam. Or if they're having a problem, you help them out. You help them out. Yeah, because that's what friends do. They help each other when they have problems. If a friend is drooping or sad, do something sweet. How can you cheer up a friend? What's the best way to cheer up a friend that you know of? Amara, can you think of something? If one of your friends were sad, what could you do to cheer them up?
I don't know. Give them a hug.
Give them a hug. That's a great idea. Do you have another idea, Natalia?
Maybe talk to them and then you can go play.
Talk to them and invite them to come play? Sure. Good friends stand by each other in rain or shine. So in the good times and in the bad. Good friends make things brighter. And they make each other happy, right? I love this picture. To grow a garden of friends, remember that new buds can sprout. In surprising places. So what are they talking about now? To make a garden of flowers or a garden of friends, remember that new buds can sprout. New flowers can come up in a garden and new friends can pop up too, right? So it's good to introduce yourself to new friends in your class or in your school, to talk to new people on the playground and be friends with everybody, because there's always room for one more friend, right? The more, the merrier. And that's the end of the story, How to Grow a Friend. Can you think of something, like what does it mean to be a good friend? What's something important that you have to remember if you want to be a good friend to somebody? Or think of a good friend that you have. What makes them be a good friend? Mom?
Like if you're just meeting them or if you don't just, like, you know them and you just want to play with them.
So introduce yourself to new people, maybe? Do you want to go put a flower up on our board there? Do you want to draw a flower? Very good. Dominic, what makes a good friend?
Someone who will never let you down.
Someone who will never let you down. I like that. Will you go write that on the board and you can draw a picture to go with it too if you want. Natalia, what makes a good friend? Why are you a good friend? I know you have a lot of friends. Why? Why do people like to hang out with you?
Because like if you're nice to them and you're not like mean to them and like saying no, you're not allowed to do this or that, then they'll like be mean to you. And if you're nice to them, they'll always want to play.
Right, so it's important not to be bossy and to always be nice. Do you want to write that on the board or draw a picture to go with it?
Because I have a friend who's bossy.
Yeah, I think we've all met some kids like that at one time or another, and grown-ups too, who have been kind of bossy. And that's not always the best way to be a friend or to keep a friend. Good. All right, so we'll put our little pictures, our friendship pictures up on the board, and then we're going to go ahead and get started with our next selection, the second book that we read to kids in Bethel Park. In the first graders throughout Bethel Park, they got to hear Duck in the Fridge. And this one is by Jeff Mack. Okay, so you guys had some great tips, and thank you for putting those up on my board. Like I said, we're ready for book number two, and the second selection is called Duck in the Fridge. It's by Jeff Mack. Now, in this story, the little boy hears the same bedtime story every night. His dad always reads to him Mother Goose. How many of you think you remember your nursery rhymes from when you were a baby or a toddler? I wonder if our friends at home know their nursery rhymes. Why don't you guys turn around for just a little bit? You can say, wave hi to the camera again. I'm gonna sort of quiz you, okay? I'm gonna start a nursery rhyme and I wanna see if you can finish it. So friends at home, you can play too. I'm gonna start it, you're gonna finish it. So what if I went like this? Hickory dickory dock. The mouse ran up the clock. The clock struck one.
The mouse came down. Dickory, dickory, dock.
Hickory, dickory, dock. You got it. Close enough. You're one for one. Okay, let's do another one. What if I said, hey, diddle, diddle, the cat and the fiddle.
The cow jumped over the moon.
The little dog laughed. Oh, no, to see such a sight, and the
cow jumped over the moon.
The dish ran away with the spoon. Spoon rhymes with moon. Yeah, you repeated that same line. Okay, let's try that again. It goes, hey, diddle, diddle, the cat and the fiddle. The cow jumped over the moon. The little dog laughed to see such a sight, and the dish ran away with the spoon. Okay, now you're one for two. Let me give you another one. Oh, I bet you'll know this one. Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. Jack
fell down and broke his crown, and Jill came tumbling after.
Good, two for three. Okay, I'm gonna give you another one. Bad, bad black sheep, have you any wool? Yes, sir, three bags full. stumped you again. One for my master, one for my dame, and one for the little boy who lives down the lane. Sound familiar? Baa, baa, black sheep, have you any wool? Yes, sir, three bags full. Okay, I'm just going to give you one more, okay? I think I'm going to think of an easy one here. What about this one? I'll make you a beat again. Peas porridge hot, peas porridge cold, peas porridge in the pot. 9 days old. Oh my goodness, I stumped you. I wonder how many of those my friends at home got. Anyway, those are some good old fashioned Mother Goose nursery rhymes. They're classics. They've been around forever. And in this story, the dad reads Mother Goose to his child every night. And then the boy's curious. He says, Daddy, why do you always read me Mother Goose before bed? Well, it all started when I found a duck in the fridge. A duck in the fridge? The little boy's like, what? That's right. One night when I was a kid, I found a duck in the fridge. Hi there. What a mess. When I went to get a towel, I found three more ducks. Hi there. Hi there. Hi there. Could you imagine a duck in your bathtub?
No.
One popping out of your toilet? One in the refrigerator?
One in the sink.
One in the sink. I tried to get ready for bed, but the ducks were everywhere. I couldn't brush my teeth. You guys say the hi there.
Hi there.
Hi there.
I couldn't put on my PJs.
Hi there.
And worst of all, I couldn't sleep.
Hi there.
Got any crackers?
Got any crackers? I gave the ducks some crackers, but they ate them all. Then they ordered out for pizza. Who's going to pay for all this? What did the duck say?
Just put it on my bill.
Get it? Just put it on my bill? Like the ducks have a bill, that's what their beak is called, and then like a bill for the pizza? So I called 1-800-DUCK-BE-GONE, and they sent me a special kit to scare away the ducks. Make sure it's very scary. That's not scary.
Hi there.
Hi there.
Now who's saying hi there?
Sheep.
They sent them a crate of sheep to scare away the ducks. Would that work? I don't think sheep are very scary. Let's find out. The sheep just sat there watching TV. The ducks were not afraid. Buy more pizza. Buy more pizza. And so then they say, hey,
we should buy more pizza.
We should buy more pizza. So I ordered a bigger, better, scarier kit. Hey, I said scary, not hairy. What did they send them?
Dogs.
Dogs. Hi there.
Hi there.
Hi there.
Got any pizza?
Got any pizza? Oh my goodness. Are dogs going to be able to scare away sheep and ducks?
Ducks are
going to cute little furry dogs? Probably not. He might run out of money. That's a good point, Natalia. I wonder where he's getting the money to pay for these kits. Putting it on Dad's credit card, maybe. Ooh, that didn't work either. The dog stayed up all night playing cards. Got any twos? I love card games. There's another joke. So they're playing, what are they playing here? When you ask somebody, you got any twos? Got any threes? You're playing go fish. And so the duck says, I love cod games. Cod is a type of fish. But cod sounds like card games. Meanwhile, the ducks and the sheep started their own band. Hey kid, name that tuna. Rock and roll. There was only one thing left to do. This is starting to get out of control. So what do you think the kid's going to do next?
I don't know.
We need an idea. What do you think he's thinking? Natalia?
He will scare them away.
The kid's going to scare them away. How will he do that?
I don't know.
Okay, let's find out if you're right. Call his friends for some help. Oh, this crate's much bigger. Danger, contains one herd of cattle. Duck and sheep and dog be gone. Holy cow, watch out. Okay, now he opens the door and he says, now that's scary. That is kind of scary. How's a cow even going to fit through the front door?
I was going to say, how can three cows fit through?
Fit in the crate? Well, it is a big crate. It was on a big truck. All right, let's see if the cows scare them away. Well, those cows didn't scare anyone, but they did throw a wild party. How was I ever going to get to sleep now? And what are they saying? I'll take the Queen of Hearts. Pick a card, any card. Care for some cheese with those crackers? No, I'm on a diet. Read any good books lately? I'm a duck. I can't read. He can talk, but he can't read. Oh, my goodness. So, that's when I saw the light. Okay, now it looks like he does have a good idea. Wait a minute. Did he say read? Maybe I didn't need to scare them away after all. What's he thinking? Mind if I borrow this? My hat. Duck was balancing the book on his head. And the kid takes it off and he says, mind if I borrow this? So what is the kid going to do? He's going to read them a book. I opened the book and started to read. There was an old woman who lived in a shoe. She had so many children, she didn't know what to do. She what? How did she fit all those kids inside one tiny shoe? Maybe it was a boot. They're enjoying the story, aren't they? They seemed curious, so I read some more. Hey, diddle, diddle, the cat and the fiddle, the cow.
Jumped over the moon.
Wow, cool. Why did she jump over the moon? To get to the utter side. Get it? Why is that funny? Utter.
Because cows have udders.
Cows have udders, right? Get to the other side. Oh, she said utter. They liked it. They really liked it. More, more, more. I said, if everyone goes to sleep right now, I promise I'll read more tomorrow night. And guess what? They went to sleep, just like that. The next night, I read the book again, and the same thing happened. Not only was it fun to read, but we all got plenty of sleep. So that's why I read Mother Goose to you every night. Good night, kiddo. Good night, Daddy. He has the stuffed duck, yeah. Good night, everyone. What?
He still kept them.
Did he keep them? Or is he thinking that? Was that a dream? Could they all still really be there? No. I don't know.
I bet.
The end. So what did you think about that one, Duck in the Fridge? That was the number two contender. And the next story we brought to kids in Bethel Park was the story called TLC. Now, TLC is an acronym. An acronym, friends, are letters, initials, that stand for something. So TLC actually stands for three words. Do you have any guesses as to what those words could be?
Yes.
You do? Okay, don't tell. We'll read it first, okay, so our friends at home can figure it out. And this one is written and illustrated, written by M.H. Clark and illustrated by Shahab Shamsharaz. Mom! I said when I came home, come play with me. Oh, sweetie, Mom said, I'm too tired. I could really use a little TLC. TLC, I thought. TLC? I don't know what that is, but I'm going to get it for her. I ran into the kitchen. I had an idea. I cracked and I measured. I squeezed and I zested. I whisked and I whipped, and finally, my TLC was complete. She made a mess in the kitchen, but she was doing something nice for Mommy. What was she making? Ta-da! I said. said, one delicious tart lemon custard. T-L-C. Tart lemon custard. Thanks, sweetie, Mom said, but she didn't open her eyes. Oh no, I thought. TLC must mean something else. I thought and I thought. I was full of good ideas. I made a phone call. I made another. Mom had lots of TLC coming her way. Who is she calling?
I don't know.
Neither. Look, Mom, I said as I opened the door. TLC! Tiny licking chihuahuas! And tiny licking chihuahuas ran into the room. They licked my mom. They licked each other. They licked me. They rolled in the custard, and they got custard paw prints everywhere. Sweetheart, Mom said, that's not quite what I had in mind. Then try this, I said. I opened the door. In came a man with lots of tattoos. He had a net in his hand. I'm the tattooed lobster catcher you called for, he said. Have you seen my lobster anywhere? I can help you find him, I said, looking around the living room, but my mom covered her face and sighed. Does TLC stand for tattooed lobster catcher?
No.
Probably not. Not what she meant.
Lobster's
right there. And do you see the lobster? Yes, right under the chair. See if you can find that lobster hiding on every page. So I opened the door, and in came a woman with a very big box. She opened it. A bright cloud of something flew out. Mom! Tropical ladybug collection! But my mom shook her head.
I found the lobster.
Where's the lobster?
On the table.
On the table with the lamp and the remote control. Good spotting. Okay, so TLC does not stand for Tropical Ladybug Collection either. So I opened the door again, and in came a tie-dyed llama cartwheeling. The llama flipped over and over, faster and faster. My mom looked upset. Maybe she wanted something friendlier? Tie-dyed llama cartwheeling. So I opened the door, and in slumped a timid lavender creature. It was 10 feet high and covered in fur. I couldn't see its eyes. The creature sat down next to my mom, and it patted her knee. But she didn't look any happier. Actually, she looked a little scared. So TLC doesn't stand for timid lavender creature either. What does it stand for?
I don't know.
Let's keep reading to find out. So I opened the door again, and some trombone-loving clowns came in. They started to play. The lavender creature tapped its toes. The llama listened. The ladybugs flew everywhere. The lobster catcher stood still and watched. The chihuahuas licked, and I danced and danced. But Mom didn't seem to like the music. So it's not trombone-loving clowns either. Hey, do you see the lobster on this page? Look carefully. My friends at home, can you spot the lobster? He is on here somewhere.
I see it.
Natalia, where is he?
He's in the trombone.
He got stuck in the trombone. Do you see his antenna and his eyes sticking out? So I opened the door again, and in came a trapezing lemur circus. They set up their trapezes without a peep, and then they hung and they swung and they flew overhead. I clapped and I clapped, but Mom did not. Mom doesn't look any happier, does she?
The lobster's on the trapeze.
And the lobster is on the trapeze. Very good. Along with all those lemurs. Just then, the wall shook. Everyone watched as the back end of a truck broke through. It beeped. Beep, 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 beep. Uh-oh. Now what's being delivered? I can only imagine.
It's chocolate.
Chocolate?
Yep.
Chocolate. Let's see. A truck of liquid chocolate! I shouted as delicious warm chocolate made a huge puddle in the living room. I jumped in. I waited around. And then, suddenly... What? Stop! Mom yelled. Stop! She's had enough. I don't know. A truckload of liquid chocolate, that would make my day.
I see.
But it's kind of messy in the living room, right? You can't have chocolate everywhere. And now the chihuahuas are in it, and the lemurs are in it.
I see the...
You see the lobster? Where is he?
In the guy's...
Oh! He's in his back pocket of the tattooed lobster catcher. Okay, so Mom's fed up. Mom's had enough. Stop! I don't need tart lemon custard, Mom said. Or tiny licking chihuahuas. Or a tattooed lobster catcher, or a tropical ladybug collection, or a tie-dyed llama cartwheeling, or a timid lavender creature, or trombone-loving clowns, or a trapezing lemur circus. And I certainly don't need a truck of liquid chocolate. She looked at me very seriously. What I need is a little tender, loving care. TLC, boys and girls, stands for Tender Loving Care. So when Mom says she needs a little TLC, that means she needs a hug and a kiss, some peace and quiet, right? A little cuddle time, maybe. Oh, I said, I can do that. So I sat down on the couch and gave my mom a very big hug. And a chocolatey hug. My mom doesn't seem to mind. Look, Mom's finally smiling. That, said Mom, is just what I needed.
And she does need those.
Where's the lobster? Where was the lobster?
Oh, where's the lobster on this page? Can we find it? I think it appears on every... Oh, yeah, I see it. He jumped from the tattooed lobster's catcher back pocket onto his... Shoulder, you got it. There's the lobster. All right, so TLC, Tender Loving Care. I think all of you after today's book nook should go give your mom and your dad and your brothers and sisters a little TLC. Go give them a great big hug or blow them a kiss. You can do it right now. Love it. Cousin time. Big hug. Yay! So friends at home, you can come and look for this book and check it out and enjoy it again at home. And of course, you can check out any of the books that we have here at the Bethel Park Public Library. And I do hope you'll do that. You'll come and visit me soon. If I don't see you before the start of school, I wish you a wonderful school year, and I'll see you in the schools. And to my two wonderful, beautiful nieces and nephews, good luck to you as you go back to St. Joseph, Michigan, and you start school up there. Can you wave bye to everybody? Thanks for being part of the show. And Natalia, I hope you have a great, terrific third grade year at South Fayette. Wave to the camera. All right. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Bye-bye, and we'll see you next time on Missy Lane's Book Nook. So long.